Hello everyone, Cutting Tool Designer here. Welcome to part 16 of the restoration of the South Bend Heavy 10 lathe. Today we're going to look at starting to put back together the gearbox. We're going to check some things out, so we'll go through that as we do it. I want to real quickly show where we're at on the apron. Finally got that piece out, and I'll show you what I did with that real quick. Then we'll start working on checking the gearbox and starting the assembly work. So hang on 1 second, we'll be right back. Okay, so here we are with the apron. As you can see, it's cleaning up pretty nicely. A lot of work on this one. Of course, here's the gear selector shaft that I couldn't get out before. And I quite frankly have no clue how they got that thing in there in the first place. And I'm going to try and see if we can get you in close enough to see what's going on here. But this has to be lined up in this direction. Now, when I would go to come up, it would hit the bottom of this housing right here. So what I had to do is go in and actually grind away some of the material underneath here. And now it'll push up and come to the side, and now I'm able to get it out. But I could not believe that there was no way to get that out of there. They had to have gotten it in somehow. And what I used was die grinder and a burr. And I went down in there and just kind of ground away some material enough to get it out. And it looks like I nicked this a little bit, but that shouldn't be a problem. So anyways, that's how that's supposed to come out of there before it was hitting this ledge right here on the part piece. Now I can slide this down in here and come at it slightly sideways. And it goes back in. Okay, so that's how that functions. Should have been not that difficult. There's only one way to go in and one way to come out, and had to figure it out. So we just had to grind some material away and then it come out. All right, hang on 1 second. We'll come back to the gearbox. Okay, here we are with the gearbox all painted up and ready to go, all cleaned up. And one of the things you want to do is, these are the pins then for the selectors, to make sure they go in a hole. You get a little bit of paint in there, and what I did is just took a quarter inch, and these are quarter inch holes. This pin here is about 245, so about 5 thousandths, and just remove any paint. So you can see it goes in there pretty easy. This one I haven't done yet, so it doesn't go in too smoothly. So we'll just show you real quick this last one. I've done all the other holes. So you just by hand take the drill and go in there and just kind of rotate it around and clean some of the paint out of there. And fits in perfectly fine now. Alright. Now that that's out of the way, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna inspect some of our bores. And this is these two here are for the cross shaft. Get you back up here a little bit. And this shaft goes in here. Actually, it's supposed to go in the other way, but then there's a pin that goes in here to lock it in here so that it can spin. As you can see, this was pretty well boogered up. There's a lot of score marks on it, and I might want to replace that at some point. So anyways, just going to check where our size is at. And let's see where we're at here. Alright, so I'm trying to see if I can get this in a shot. So I'm going to measure this shaft. Supposed to be 7/8, All right, so 874.1. So that's not too bad. But as we go down here, now it's down to 873.1 and 873.1. Check the other side. And out at the shaft areas. Now see here we've got a bit of wear. That's 870 and 4/10. So there's a lot of wear in that end of the bearing. And I think the bushing 872.5 and 872.6. So on average about 872 for the shaft. But if we add that up, now these are the tri-mics, internal tri-mics. The pins stick out and rotate around, and you put them in the bore, and we'll see if we can get this in here at all for you to see. But anyway, this line, every one of the little lines is 2/10. So that's 900 thousandths, or 1 inch rather, 975, 950, 925, 800, or 900, excuse me. And then another rotation around right to here would be 875. So we're going up, get it in the bore here far enough to do this by hand. Line it up and ratchet it. So we got 870. This is 875, 876, 877, 878. And it looks to be about 3.5 marks, about 7/10. So that's 878. So that's 3 over nominal. And the shafts were at least 3 under nominal. So you've got over 6/1000 of clearance in there, which I think is a bit. And if I measure it further up in, it actually gets worse. So 678, and about 4/10. And that's on that side. And then I flip it around to the other side. It's 875, 6, 7, 8, 9, 880. So that's quite a bit of slop. I'm thinking that the bushings I'm probably going to want to replace at some point, and the shaft, I know there's supposed to be clearance in there, but this seems to be excessive. Of course, the oil loss. I mean, I'm pulling back and forth, up and down, so oil loss is going to be high, even with the wicks put in. So, with that said, we'll probably at some point tear this back down again. I'd like to make another shaft, only because it's so scored up. And I'd like to bring that tolerance up a little closer. It has to be loose enough for the tumblers to travel back and forth. But anywho, what we're going to start with, I think, first is we're going to start by putting in the Christmas tree shaft, which is this shaft right here. I've already put the key in. It sits down in the slot. Interesting thing is, I was measuring these all up and laying them out so I could draw them up if I wanted to make new shafts. Here we have, this is basically a 5/8 shaft here. If we can get down to it here without wasting too much time. And go back to, okay. So we're measuring 623.9, 624, And if I go in where the first gear sets, 624, so a thou under. If I get it on the ridge where it's there's a gap between the gears, 624.1. If I go further back here, I'm dropping down 623.9. So there's lines here, you can feel them. 624, so they're not too bad. The shaft isn't too bad. And I got some slop on the bores there too. So we got the key here, we've got to put a wick in here. So the wick, that we need from the kit is type 1. It's 16 inch thick and an 1/8 inch wide. It has to go in here and you just need to press it in and then trim it off. They say to pull it if it's a little too tight, so that's what we'll do. And quit pulling it out, it would be better, huh? Okay. Now we'll have to be real careful when we put the gears on. And this takes, this assembly takes type B oil. So I think I'm gonna back you out just a little bit, so you can see a little better as to what we're doing. And so we have the wick sitting in there. We'll stretch it out some more. We'll wait to go to put some oil on it until we start putting the gears in. I'll put these away so they're not in the way. And the other thing we need to do is we need to fill all the little holes down in the oilers with this 3/16 wick. And they say about a 1/4 inch piece. All we want to do is put that in the bottom of the hole so the oil doesn't run out. And this should be fun. Really should have something like a pair of tweezers or something. But I'm just going to use this small Allen wrench. See if we can work it in there. We're not. Better drop it on the floor for one. So it doesn't seem to want to go in there too easily. I just got to get it started though. Just got to get it started. Got it on the hole. So you guys can see how painful this is. Definitely not something that you're going to spend too much online watching. Alright, let me pause this and I'm going to go ahead and get these wicks in and I'll show you what they look like when we're done. So hang on, I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. Finally got those in there and I used the point of a pin driver. Let's try to move some of this other stuff out of the way. Alright, so we have this gear too that we, or gear, bearing that we've got to put in here, and it has to go into this slot. This is the notchy replacement that I got. It's just a deep groove radial bearing, and decide which way I want to try and push this in. I may try. Let's see. It's smooth. It's going in slowly. May actually use. Take that wick out for now. May actually use this to tap it in. Or maybe not. Let's see. That goes in there pretty tight, so it's going to be tight on that bearing. So just keep trying to work it in, I guess. Maybe I can go, let's see if I can find my channel locks here. Maybe we can kind of gently squeeze this in a couple different spots. Just go back and forth. Try not to put any real pressure on it. Getting there. All right, let me go ahead and get that in the rest of the way. We'll be right back. All right, I got it in there, but it's going to want to move that way when we tap it in there because it's a press fit on this part of the shaft. So we're just going to play this by ear as we go through. So here's our gears. And we gotta go in this sequence. And I'll go ahead and take the wire out. And we have a pin here too that has to go into these gears here that keeps them from anti-rotating. So we're gonna have to slowly start working this. I'm gonna throw a little bit of oil in there. A little bit of oil in here, and maybe just a dab on that bearing to get us started. So now I'm gonna bring this in, and we gotta start loading these gears on under the key. So here's the first gear. Second gear, third gear. It looks like I messed up that wick already. Yeah, this is gonna be a pain in you know what. Crap, boy. You know, a lot of other people have the same kind of problem with this thing. So let's get these gears worked up to a certain spot. We'll just keep putting them on. Go ahead and start lining up in this keyhole. Wait till we get it on the shaft further. That still can take the key. And that's the last one that holds it. So we're going to have to try and get this key in here. So drag through there. Just there we go. into that one, push through, find a hole in that one, push through, hole in that one, push it through, hole in that one. It should come back, stick out a little bit for this gear. And that locks that one in place. Okay. That at least helps align the keys. The key slots. What's up with that? Stuck together. Alright. Put that gear in. Put that gear in. Now we still have to get this gear in. Now this was supposed to be pinned in. Went to go to the hardware store and they were closed. So that bearing, I may have to push that bearing out further. To get this in, because it has to go in that far. So let's tap this a little bit. Oh, there, bearing sliding out through. All right. So now we can maybe find the key. Man, those are tight on there for some reason. yeah. All right, it's not going very smoothly. Some reason doesn't want to slide up on there. So I'm probably gonna have to play with this for a little bit until probably gonna have to push that bearing out completely from that side and then put it back in. That's what I have a feeling I'm gonna have to do. So I can tap those on, I guess. Because this has to go in there, and there's just no way it's going to fit there. Just no way, Jose. All right, let me play with this a little bit, and we'll come back. All right. Hang on a second. Okay, everybody. Not having such good luck with reassembling this at the moment. I did find out, taking it all back apart, that I need to go in and clean out the bores on these a little bit better. Some of them just, they cannot slide on, and that's really what's causing the issue. So I got to get these cleaned up so that they all at least slide on freely, and I'll go through the whole set on the shaft to make sure. And then we'll get back to the reassembly again. In the meantime, let me just show you the main handle for the apron. All cleaned up, painted, polished, turned out pretty good. I mean, it still has some nicks and stuff in it, but I'm not gonna spend that much time on it. It looks pretty darn good, I think, as it is. So, hopefully I got that in the shot. Try it again. Peek in the camera here. Maybe I can determine that I'm actually doing something that you can see. And, painting up some more spot stuff. This is the handle for, I gotta paint the bottom yet, for the clutch assembly. And just a bunch of other stuff. So this episode wasn't as successful as I was hoping it would be. I think next time we get into this, pretty soon, what I'm going to do is go through and make sure everything fits appropriately on the shafts. That way we can put it together a little bit smoother, I hope. Okay? So, here's the tag. There's the tag for the outside. Got it cleaned up real well. Turned out pretty nice. A couple minor dings in it, but nothing major. So, anywho, we'll go ahead and wrap this up. Sorry for your inconvenience of watching the mess up, but sometimes you gotta see how things don't go so well. So hopefully that'll help somebody else out. So if you want to keep following along, please subscribe so you get a notification. If you're liking anything we're doing, please give me a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it. Also, please feel free to leave comments. I'm trying to get back to everybody that leaves comments. So thoughts, suggestions, anything like that, references to anything else. Ooh, which, by the way, on those tri-mics that we looked at here at the beginning, Pierre, let's see, what is Pierre's? Pierre Boucher, I think, something like that. Pierre is in Canada, in the French Quarter. He just posted a video on how to use tri-mics, how to adjust them so that you can put the extensions on, how to calibrate them, and he goes through a whole learning curve showing everybody how to use them. So I will post a link to his video showing that. Nice man. I met him last year, and appreciate if you go check him out. So until next time, this will be the end of episode 16. Stay tuned to 17, where hopefully we'll have a successful assembly of the gearbox. All right, everyone. Take care.